Okay, so in this video, what I want to do is show you a little bit about the tools and settings for the Google Ads campaigns. So if we go up here and we look at the different settings here, we can look at there's different areas, and most of this is pretty self-explanatory. So we obviously have here the billing. This is where we're going to be adding our payment information so that we can run the ads. Then we have the setup here. This is our business data. And then policy manager as far as the Google Ads policy. And then this is a brand new feature here, custom dimensions, not really sure what this is. And then the account access, it's essentially allowing us to designate who we want to give access to our account, okay? And then we have linked accounts if we want to link maybe one account to another, our different preferences here, and then the merchant center for Google. And then the measurement here, this is where we're going to see our conversions for like our data as far as how many leads we've received or how many purchases we've received. And then we have the Google Analytics. This is where we're going to see all of our data as far as the visitors that have came onto our website. And then the search attribution. This is essentially showing us which keywords are people typing in and then seeing our ads and then clicking on so that they can become an actual lead. And then here we have the bulk actions if we want to update several things at once. And then the shared library. So this is the audience manager, where if we want to create remarketing campaigns, retargeting campaigns, and then the bid strategies here. And then the negative keyword list. This is essentially where we're going to add keywords that we don't want our ads to show up on. So for example, let's say that we're looking for a high ticket client or a high ticket lead, and we don't want our ad to show up when people are looking for discount or cheap or affordable, right? We would add in those related keywords so that whenever somebody's typing in, let's say discount services or affordable services, we will not have our ad show up when those keywords are searched, because we only want to show our ads to people that are willing to spend and that have that actual budget, right? So that's why we want to add those keywords to the negative keyword list. And then here on the placement exclusion list, so let's say that we have an ad that is going to be showing up on various platforms, such as the display network and then the search network as well. Well, this is where we can actually create an exclusion list and actually only show our ad on one particular area or the other. And then here we have the keyword planner. So this area here is really about understanding keyword research, doing keyword research so that we can come in here and look for the most profitable keywords. And this is going to be a great tool that we can use. However, I'm also going to be walking you through several different tools that we can use in conjunction to the keyword planner here through Google. And then we're going to be able to look at a lot of the keywords that we can integrate and add into our specific ads. And then over here on the left, we can see the campaign here, crawl space cleaning number one. And then we have the ad groups, okay? The crawl space cleaning and then the crawl space insulation. These are two separate ads here that we're going to be targeting people who are looking just for the crawl space cleaning, and then one for the crawl space insulation, okay? And then we have our keywords down here for the crawl space cleaning, okay? Here we have the negative keywords. We don't have any because we haven't added this yet. This is just more an example here to show you what all the buttons do here in the tools and settings. And then we're going to dive deeper in other videos. So that's going to be here for this one, and we'll see you on the next one.